With iOS 13, you can finally play iOS games on your iPhone or iPad with your Xbox One controller. And fortunately, it's really easy to set up as long as you have the right controller, and we're going to show you how to do that. Here's what you need. First, you're going to need iOS 13 or iPadOS 13 if you're on an iPad. And right now, that means you're going to need to be on the beta, which I'll warn you is a little buggy. Now, here's where it gets a little complicated. You're going to need a Bluetooth wireless controller, which that means you need model 1708. This is the one that came with the Xbox One S. It's the only one that supports Bluetooth. Earlier ones, like this one, wireless controllers will not support it. And you can tell if you look in closely because this one has a little segment around the Xbox logo, and that means it doesn't support it. It all look like one face. Alternatively, later this year, you can use the Elite 2 controller that costs $180, but it will also work with Bluetooth and it will work with your phone. So to set this up, first you're going to go into settings, then you're going to go into Bluetooth. Make sure that this toggle is turned to green because otherwise your Bluetooth isn't on. We have sometimes found that it's easier to pair stuff if you just do a reset like this really quickly. So our Bluetooth is running. So we're going to pick up our Xbox controller. Now you have two ways to do this. If your controller has never been paired to anything else, like this one is, holding down on the Xbox button for a few seconds will be enough to start the pairing process. If it is already paired to something else, like an Xbox button, first you're going to want to hold this down to turn it on, and then this button on the back here, you're going to want to hold that down for about 5 seconds instead of the Xbox home button. And so in this case, again, we're going to press the home button and the light should start flashing quickly. Immediately over here on the phone, we see Xbox wireless controller would like to pair with your phone. We're going to pair that, and immediately it's paired, and that's all there is to it. You can see here from the light being stable that it is paired, and then you can use it with any MFI controller compatible game on iOS. So if you're done playing and you want to disconnect your Xbox One controller, you have two ways of doing it. On the Xbox One controller itself, you could just simply hold down the button here for about 5 seconds and it should just shut off entirely. And there, you don't even have to worry about doing anything on the phone. Alternatively, let's turn it back on. There, it's already connected again. You can go into your control center on your iPhone, go to the Bluetooth menu here, hold it down, and then you'll see Bluetooth Xbox One wireless controller. Hold that down, and you can scroll to the bottom right here on mine at least where it says Xbox wireless controller. Press that, and as you can see, it disconnects. If you're on a trip or something and you don't want to use your controller, or you're afraid, like, you know, something in your bag will accidentally do it, it's really easy. You just unpair it and you go to this eye here, forget this device, and it's unpaired. To pair it again, you'll have to go through that same process, but as you saw, it's really quick.